Venimos aquí a compartir una historia de un restaurante muy improbable. Quizá tendría más sentido.
We came here to tell a story about a very improbable restaurant.
Unlikely. Puede ser que tuviera más sentido que existiera como una posibilidad y no como una realidad.
It existed in, when I say improbable, in the sense that it existed as a possibility, not as a reality.
Es un restaurante que gira alrededor de una familia.
It's a restaurant that revolves around a family.
Curiosamente, yo, el que lo hice, soy el único que no soy de sangre familiar de ellos.
Strangely enough, I am... El otro nombre era... El otro nombre. Tú y...
Jair Rafael,
Rafael
Armando.
Armando. So, curiously enough, Jair and Rafael are the only ones who aren't family, blood relations.
Yeah.
Yeah? Más o menos. Oh, no. No, no, sí. No. Que me... Entonces, que me...
Basically, I'm the only one who's not a relative.
Ah, okay.
Rafael y Armando se han convertido para mí en una de las personas que más quiero, de las personas que más estimo a través de los años.
Rafael is one of the people that I admire and love the most over the course of years.
Tiene una integridad y honestidad para trabajar que jamás se había visto.
He has one of the greatest in integrity and dedication to work that I've ever seen.
Y es un privilegio que la vida me ha dado trabajar con ellos y convivir con ellos y toda su familia.
And it's been a great privilege to work and share these projects with them over the years.
Quizá ahora ya empezamos a ser un poco parientes, ¿no?
Okay, so right now maybe we're going to start to be a little braver.
Gran parte de mi carrera se lo debo a ellos.
I owe a great deal of my career to them.
Porque yo vivo en la Ciudad de México y tengo otros restaurantes y justo puedo hacer eso porque sé que ellos están cuidando.
Because I live in Mexico City, but I'm able to do this because of where they are.
El restaurante lo manejan ellos. Lo manejan ellos porque yo los empoderé.
They are the ones who actually manage the restaurant. They manage it because I empowered them to do it.
Pero a su vez ellos me han empoderado a mí porque el empoderamiento funciona en dos sentidos.
But at the same time they've empowered me. Power works in, the empowerment works in both directions.
Ellos todos los días me recuerdan que a veces aunque yo no lo crea sirvo de algo para el restaurante.
Every day they remind me that even though I sometimes don't believe it, that I serve something, I function, I mean something for this restaurant.
Para explicarles cómo va el tema del parentesco, les cuento.
Okay, let me explain how the family relationship works.
It's like a kinship thing.
The kinship, good.
Armando, Rafael son hermanos.
Armando and Rafael are brothers.
Armando maneja el jardín, la huerta.
Armando manages the garden, the vegetable garden.
Rafael es el jefe de cocina.
Rafael is the chef de cuisine.
El jefe del salón.
The front of house manager.
Está casado con una hermana de Rafael y Armando.
Is married to a sister.
Y hay un cocinero, el pelón, que es hijo de un hermano del jefe del salón.
Y hermana también.
And we have another chef who's the brother of the floor manager.
Well, yeah, the dining room chef is married to a sister of them. And then there's a cook who is actually the son of their sisters and the other guy's brother.
El primo.
Y el lavalosa.
Did you have a question?
No, but he was speaking perfect English.
I can speak before the English. I can. If you're better, if we don't. Because when we started the interview, we need translation. Right now, I grew up in Tijuana, come on. So 15 years ago, I think we have a very nice picture of when I was this chubby, dreamy, chubby cook that wanted to make a Destiny restaurant in the middle of the countryside in Baja, which was totally nonsense. I guess, you know, European Basque style, whatever. So yeah, I thought I had enough talent to achieve that. And now I don't remember for sure, but I might have had plans to impersonate that chef that I worked, you know, that screamed and, you know, give shit to my cooks and create that discipline. But after the kinship I explained to you, and being in the middle of a countryside with nobody else, basically, difficult to get employees, it was 15 years ago, I had to stick. My priority was to stick with my team, which meant there was no possibility for me to impersonate that screaming chef. So I had to eat shit, basically, because it made all sense that I ate shit. The moment I start screaming, then I become the priority, and all the energy goes towards me, then I put at risk everything else. We've gone through difficult times, you know, many days of with no customers, and that's emotionally draining for a team and for a restaurant, you know? We like people to eat food. All of us had reasons to not to be together at some point. I mean, it hasn't been a fairy tale. But somehow we have all realized that our effort is to stay together, no matter what, because that's what really makes us, enables us to do what we do. And this is it. Now we can start translating, because we'll do the interviews.
Okay.
Rafa, ustedes trabajaron siempre en familia, ¿no? Yo los conocí siendo trabajadores de campo.
I met them when they as
field workers.
For field workers, yeah.
Y trabajaban en familia. El papá el jefe.
Mm-hmm. They worked as a family. Their father was the boss.
Su hermano mayor, el segundo jefe.
The eldest brother was the second in boss.
Y hermanos y hermanas.
And there were other brothers and sisters.
Y ahora trabajamos en restaurante como familia.
And now we work in the restaurant as a family.
Y nos ponemos a pensar, ¿cómo fue que llegaste a Laja?
¿Otra vez?
¿Cómo fue? How was it that you...
How was it that you...
¿Y qué significa para ti Laja?
To come to the restaurant like that.
Sería muy fácil para mí escribirlo.
It would be much easier for me to write it.
Pero no sé escribir ni leer.
But he doesn't know how to read or write.
Es que no os oigo muy bien. ¿Otra vez?
But he doesn't know how to read nor write.
But he doesn't know how to read and write.
Así que voy a tener que platicarles un poquito de mi historia, ¿no?
So I'll tell you a bit of my story.
Sucedió aquel día cuando apareció un loco montañés gordito, pero con barba. Con montañés.
He was a sort of chubby peasant with a beard. Mm-hmm.
Con botas y todo.
Wearing boots, everything.
Llega en un Toyota.
Arrived in a Toyota.
Y me dice, voy a poner un restaurante ahí.
And he said to me, I'm going to put a restaurant over there.
Pongo a pensar, digo, bueno.
And I thought, well.
Es una sola carretera, es una hora de la ciudad.
This is a highway. This guy has arrived from the city.
Y le digo, oye, ¿qué tipo de comida vas a vender aquí? ¿Unos chilaquiles o un huevito o qué?
And I asked him, what kind of food are you going to be serving here?
No, me dice, comida diferente.
No, he says, different kind of food.
Bueno, entonces cuando eso pasa, yo le digo a mi cuñado, le digo, se me hace que este es el ajumo verde.
Bueno, otra vez.
He told his brother-in-law, I think he's
okay, so he said, yeah. I said to my brother, yeah, that I think my my brother-in-law has been hitting the green stuff.
No.
Había monte, había todo. Dije, bueno, ¿quién le va a dar la comida a los caballos o a las vacas? No había nada.
I was thinking, what are they? What is, there's just like cows around here. What are they going to be eating?
Nada. Bueno, total, así pasó. Dos días después.
Mm-hmm. So this happened, and then a couple of days later.
Me dice, oye, ¿no quieres trabajar en cocina?
And he said to me, hey, don't you want to try and work in my kitchen, in the kitchen?
Y le dije, yo soy libre como los pajaritos.
I said, well, I'm as free as these birds around here.
Y dije, encerrado, 14 horas, dije, puta.
Thinking to himself.
Y entonces ya fue cuando me dijo, pues cocina, le dije, pues entramos de lavaplatos a ver qué sale.
Said, well, I think I'll sit down and I'll try it, but we'll see what happens from it.
Bueno, el siguiente día que me pone un mandil, un pantalón rayado.
So they put an apron on me with these striped pants.
Dije, puta, creo que soy de la cárcel, ¿lo que pasó?
He's looking around saying, I don't know what happened to me here.
Bueno, pasando el mes.
So after a month.
Se me empiezan a poner las manos muy lisitas.
He started to notice that his hands were getting very rough.
Se me hace que este trabajo es para mujeres.
This is work for women.
Dije, no. Y estaba lavando trastes. Y ya de repente que empieza a hacer un plato. Y yo de curioso, dije, vamos a ver qué comida va a ser.
So I started working on the dishes and I was very curious to see what kind of food is this going to be.
Y empieza a hacer una espuma ahí de pescado. Y
there was like a foam with the fish.
No sé, unos espárragos y
asparagus in there.
Y de repente que me dice, pruébala. Pues que me da un pasto verde, era la arúgula. Y dije, ay, está malito.
And somebody, he hands over to me, said, this green paste.
Y dije, bueno, grass. Vamos
okay.
A ver.
Grass.
Ahorita le voy a decir qué clase de comida va a ser, vamos a ver.
Well, okay, so we're going to see what comes of this.
Que la saca al comedor.
Brings it out to the dining room.
Y me voy atrás de la puerta a mirar.
And I was standing in the door watching.
A ver qué gestos hace el comensal.
To see what the diners think of it.
Y de repente que miro que empieza a degustarla bien y empieza y deja todo.
So and they tries, the diner begins to taste it.
Y ya de repente que le digo, ah, caray, se me hace que el que ando mal soy yo.
And I say to myself, wow, it seems to them that que,
it seems to me like the one who's wrong is me, he
okay.
says.
Okay, that he was the one that was wrong.
Allí cambió mi visión.
And so that started to change my vision of things.
Y decidí dejar todo lo mío, lo del campo.
And I decided to leave all of my work from the field.
Y meterme de lleno a la cocina.
And really dedicate myself to the kitchen.
Dije, a lo mejor, en esta profesión de mujeres, a lo mejor puede haber algo bueno.
I said to myself, okay, I know it's a profession of women, but this is what I can dedicate myself to.
¿Por qué? Porque mi trabajo era... Mi trabajo era de, no sé, 12, 13 horas en el campo, rudo, físico.
Yeah, up until that point, my work had always been in the field, 12, 13 hours a day, very hard work, very physical work.
Y entonces yo pensaba que era trabajo de mujeres porque pues, no sentía que no trabajaba.
And so I thought that cooking was women's work because I had a different conception of what work was. I hadn't seen them working.
No, it's very important. He said he thought he was not working at all, working in the kitchen.
Y ya le dije, ¿estás preparado para las preguntas? Dice, sí. ¿Dónde no te estorbo? Me dijo, allí. Okay, vámonos.
Okay, so I was ready. I was prepared with all of these questions, and I said, okay, that's the direction we're going in. Let's go.
Como aquel niño pequeño preguntón, llovía de preguntas.
Hiya. Perdón.
First he asked me, where do I really bother you? because he wanted to ask me everything on the kitchen. Okay. So I told him, there, you can stay there, and you won't bother me there.
Okay.
And then he says, okay, then I will start asking every single thing.
Everything. Okay, thanks.
Y ya de repente le digo, ahora sí que hay que hacer. Me pone el mandil, la filipina, y dijo, ay, otra cosa más caliente. Dije, no. Dije, ahora.
You have to translate this because this is
I need
like
to translate.
Slang
it's very, it's
that
very,
I'm not
it's
getting.
Very countryside slang.
This is much more Mexican slang.
Yeah, it's very Mexican. This is field worker culture. This is field worker Spanish, and we're proud of it. And it's just a dialect that we speak. And he's just joking about everything. In a nice way. So he says that when I asked him to put a chef jacket, they said, now this is worse than the apron. He says, like, no, this is warm. It's so uncomfortable.
Entonces, ya pasa el gorrito, pasa todo rayado, pasa el mandil. Dije, ah, caray, ahora vas, ¿qué más sigue?
Then he put, then now I was like, in my costume. Then I said, okay, now what's next?
Todos dicen, okay, me arrima como 20 cáscaras de naranja.
So he was, there were about, you were working with 20 orange peels, right?
Y dice, hay que picarlas muy finitas.
Okay, told him that he had to slice them very, chop them very finely.
Y empiezo, tan, tan. Se tarda media hora yo. Puta madre.
Did it take half an hour?
Ahí estoy. Bueno, dice así. Llega y le digo, ¿qué te parecen?
And I brought them to him. I said, how do they look?
Muy bien. Agarra a la basura.
And he said, fine. And he scraped them off the table and dumped them in the trash.
Le digo, hazme cinco más. Bueno. Cinco más.
Do five more for me. Does five more?
Y otra vez, ¿qué te parecen?
Again, how are these?
Agarro otra vez y las tira a la basura.
Once again, into the trash.
¿Qué le digo? ¿Cuál es tu problema?
So I say, what is your problem?
Dice, no, es que la forma del cuchillo es para que no te cortes y es la enseñanza que vas a tomar.
So he said, no, let me show you. This is the proper way to cut it. This is how I want to teach you to cut them.
Dije, ah, caray, entonces está bien. Vamos por buen camino.
And he said, okay, damn it, we're going to get, that's fine.
De repente
we'll
que me dice, oye, ¿de casualidad no tienes una hermana? Dije, ah, caray, si no te conozco, ¿ves que una hermana?
So he says, by any chance, do you have a sister?
Dije, ¿qué pasó? Pero ya que le digo, pero tengo un hermano.
He said, no, but I have a brother.
Entonces, pues yo entendí mal, porque de la hermana dije, bueno, ¿este qué? Si apenas lo conozco, me está diciendo que es mi hermana.
Okay, I understood badly. When he was asking about sister, I was thinking, why does this guy want to know about my sister?
Pero él se refería que quería gente trabajadora, cumplida.
But he was looking, what he really meant is that he was looking for more hardworking people.
Pues el que andaba mal era yo.
Just, okay. What was that last comment?
The one who was wrong, it was me again.
Oh, okay. He was the one who was wrong.
And that's his brother.
And Roman. That's the girl. That's the sister right there.
By the way, if there's any question whatsoever regarding this weird story. We'll be pleased to answer. No. I never actually achieved to make a phone. I tried. Nadie, perfect.
So what kind of food were you doing at the end?
Basically, we ended up doing the food that we can do with the garden that he grows. So it became that became the.
How is it working family together? I mean, do you ever want to kill each other, basically?
Que si pasa que de repente quieres agarrar de las greñas a la familia porque estás junto y te desesperas.
Yo creo que entre familia. Entre los testigos.
Sorry, sorry. Otra vez. No, I thought you were answering. Okay,
tú síguete. Date, déjate llevar.
Trabajar en familia es difícil y es fácil.
He says that to work amongst family it's difficult and at the same time it's easy.
Le enseñas las normas del trabajo, las reglas.
You can teach them the ways of the work.
Cuando logran entender el sistema del trabajo del restaurante,
when they get to know how the restaurant works,
se hace un engrane grande.
You make a big oh my God, what's the name, engrane? Or like a wheel that makes, it's a system that really is working.
Entonces se mueve al mismo nivel que el pequeño.
And it says the big wheel moves in the same way that the small one moves.
Entonces cuando tienen la visión bien clara,
when there's a very clear vision,
no hay errores, no hay.
There's no room for mistakes. There are no mistakes, and everything really fits in.
Porque cuando entienden eso, cuando él cultiva,
when they understand that, when he grows the stuff,
el vegetal con cariño va creciendo.
When the vegetable itself it's grown with care.
Llega el hermano maldoso y se lo arranca.
Then I'm the evil brother that comes and I take it from there, then I take it to
arranca.
The kitchen.
Bueno. Entonces cuando arranca un vegetal es como un niño.
When I get this vegetable, it's like a tiny child.
Lo llevamos a la mesa.
We take him to the table.
Y con esa familia,
and with this family,
empezamos a crear el plato.
Wow. We start creating a dish.
Para mí,
for me,
la comida es amor.
Food is love.
Es el trabajo de familia en equipo que pone su granito de cada quien.
It's the working family that everybody puts a little grain.
Que se divierte.
That we're having fun.
Convive, gustoso.
All doing with a lot of, you know.
Oh, I'm so hungry.
Being happy.
Por lo que hacemos.
And that's. Dale.
Es una armonía hermosa que se transforma en eso.
We create a beautiful harmony that's transformed in that food.
Y eso se lo llevan al comensal.
And we take that to the guest.
Can you tell us a little bit what kinds of vegetables he grows? I mean,
¿Qué vegetales siembras? Tú date, dime.
It depends on the season. Sorry. It depends on the season.
Ahorita, por ejemplo, está terminando con lo que, por ejemplo, tomates.
Right.
Berenjenas.
Right now, the season is ending for tomatoes, for eggplant, for fennel,
zucchini.
So then we're going to be growing tubers later. We're moving into that season. Chirivia
is
parsnip.
Parsnip.
Sir?
It's a very California weather. It's a southern California. We're very
like
close.
Is it like local? I mean, have you done like research about finding different or forgotten vegetables, or is it just the local
it's,
things?
We're in the northern end of Baja.
Okay.
And so the climate-wise, it's a very Mediterranean weather. As for, we're not in that part of Mexico where you have this ancient pre-Hispanic tradition. We're in the basically in the Alaska of Mexico. So there's no, we're not that Mexico of the corn. Actually, we didn't grow up with corn. You can make Mexican food in a Toyota truck with a baseball hat as long as you're Mexican.
Hola, Yair. Una pregunta.
Sí.
Okay. I would like to know how this model, this structure that you have with them can contribute to Tomorrow's Kitchen, which is the theme of this event. You said at the beginning that you learned that it was better not to focus on your authority or your leadership instead of spread the, I mean, to have it as a work team. And I asked this also because I know you're very critical about the role of chefs nowadays and how they should be present on the restaurants. So in general, how this model can contribute to Tomorrow's Kitchen?
Well, really fast. For me, it was a survival model because if I had done otherwise, I wouldn't have a restaurant, have had a restaurant. So if it's, I think, is it worth to invest on feelings? Is it worth to invest? Because feelings, we're talking of it, you need to nurture. The way Rafael very eloquently talked about vegetables and this system of nurture. We really definitely need to nurture ourselves as being human beings, of course. We cannot, it's no question. We cannot avoid it. That's why people are, you know, sometimes they're just not able to function. Because we need to go back to the basic, which is feelings. No matter how risky they are and how uncertain they are. But in the end, there's no way around it. There's no way I see it.
And now.